It is my pleasure and my honor to invite our speaker and interpreter to take your time and deliver the word of God to all of us. In Jesus' name, thank you.
Well, good. Thank you, brother. Appreciate that. And good evening, everybody. It is good to be with you again tonight.
Alo mingla ba di ya ma alo ne atu shi khwin ya da de ke be kaung mu ma de.
Good evening, brother Issachar, and I just want to say thank you for your labor, and I thank the God that he's given us the ability to speak with one voice.
Thank you.
Yes.
That is good.
Well, amen. Well, I want to say thanks again for each and every one of you coming out to these meetings every night, and want to thank you for the wonderful music that has been performed and the time of worship together. It's been a blessing. Turn in your Bibles, if you would please, to the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 4, chapter 13. 2 Corinthians, chapter 13 tonight. Some years ago, there was a man of God by the name of Dr. Walter Wilson that was very active in Christian service.
Dr. Walter Wilson
For 17 years, he served God, but according to his own testimony, his Christian service was fruitless. One day, Dr. Wilson was meeting with a missionary, and the missionary asked him this important question.
Dr. Wilson ga amuro sa te yaw ne tu song twei che de. Ai ya ka ma ai amuro sa ga tu go di mi kun lai mi ye ba de.
The missionary asked Dr. Wilson, "What is the Holy Spirit to you?"
Ai ya amuro sa ga Dr. Wilson ye pan shin ma wing yin do phaya ha tin atwe bedu nya le lo mi kun thauk ye ba.
And Dr. Wilson said, "Well, the Holy Spirit is one of the members of the Godhead."
Dr. Wilson ga oh tan shin lo wing yin no phaya ha soe no thong ma de su the ma pa win ne da ba ba lo tu pyan phi ke.
Then the missionary said, "Well, Dr. Wilson, you have not answered my question. What is the Holy Spirit to you?"
Ara ne amu ro saung ga Dr. Wilson tan ma Dr. Wilson ye chano ye mi khon ko khamya ma phi de bu chano mi ni da ga tan shin lo wing yin no phaya ha tin atwe bedu le.
He said, "Dr. Wilson, I want to know what the Holy Spirit means to you."
Oh, Dr. Wilson, ye tan shin lo wing yin no phaya ha soe no tin twa belaw chi a yi pa de pauku phit pa de le lo chano mi ni da ba de.
Well, Dr. Wilson thought for a moment and he had to honestly answer and say, "Well, the Holy Spirit is nothing to me. I know who he is, but I have no personal relationship with him."
Dr. Wilson got the chat to sense up, you know, so maro. Amuro sound tan ma tu pyan phi de. Tan shin lo wing yin do phya ha ngaw twet de ge ro bedu ma mo hou ba la. Tu be wa le so ra ko chano ti ro ti bi me. Chano ye atat da ma tu ne sit man le set nwe chin lo set nwe mu ro ma shi ba la ma shi de lo ba be lo pyan phi ge.
And then the missionary replied, he says, "Well, Dr. Wilson, that's the reason for the barrenness and the fruitlessness of your ministry." I remember one day I was asked that very same question that that missionary asked Dr. Wilson.
ကျွန်တော်မှတ်မိပါသေးတယ်ကျွန်တော်ကိုယ်တိုင်ပင်လည်း No kunaga missionary tyauk ka Dr. Wilson ko me khe de me khon a dai be chano ko le thulo me khe bu ba de.
I had just graduated from Bible College and I was sitting before a board of theologians for my ordination.
ကျွန်တော်ကျမ်းစာကြောင်းပြီးသွားတဲ့နောက်ပိုင်းမှာကျွန်တော်ရဲ့သာသနာလုပ်ငန်းမသွားခင်မှာကျွန်တော်ကဘုတ်အဖွဲ့ဝင်တွေကသူတို့ကကျမ်းစာကိုသိသိတဲ့ theologian တွေဖြစ်ပါတယ်သူတို့ရှိမှကျွန်တော်ကိုအာဒီမိခွန်းနဲ့အမေးဖြေတယ်ကျွန်တော်အရင်ဖြေရပါတယ်ကျွန်တော်သူတို့ရှိမှသွားရခဲ့ပါတယ
် These theologians were asking me all kinds of theological questions. They were checking my theology to see if I was qualified to be a pastor.
တကယ်တော့ဒီဘုတ်ဖွဲ့ဝင် theologian တွေကတကယ်ပဲကျွန်တော်ဘယ်လောက်ထိတမန်တရားကိုသိတယ်ကျွန်တော်ရဲ့ဩဝါဒကတိကမှန်လားမမှန်လားဆိုတဲ့အရာကိုသူတို့ကစစ်ဆေးတဲ့အနေနဲ့ကျွန်တော်ကိုမေးခွန်းနေမင်းနေခဲ့တာဖြစ်တယ
် And towards the end of the questioning, one man asked me this question. He says, "What do you know about the ministry of the Holy Spirit in your life?"
အဲ့ဒီအမေဖီရဲ့နောက်ဆုံးမိခွန်းလေးမှလူတယောက်ကကျွန်တော်ကိုမိခွန်းထုတ်ခဲ့ပါတယ်။တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ရဲ့အမှုတော်မြတ်နဲ့တင်အာဘလောက်ကြည့်ရင်းမိသလဲ။သူ့ရဲ့အမှုတော်မြတ်ကတင်းရဲ့အသက်တာမှာအာဘာရီတင်ခံစားရသလဲလို့ကျွန်တော်ကိုမိခွန်းထုတ်ခဲ့တယ်
။ And I like a well-trained Bible college student began to talk about the theology of the Holy Spirit.
ကျွန်တော်ဟာဆိုရင်ကျမ်းစာကြောင်းပြီးခါစလူတယောက်เนาะပီပီပင်ပင်ပေါ့ဒီတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်နဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့ဩဝါဒတွေကိုကျွန်တော်ပြန်ဖြေခဲ့ပါတယ
် I begin to say well the Holy Spirit is God the Holy Spirit is all powerful the Holy Spirit is everywhere present at the same time
ကျွန်တော်ဘလို့ပြန်ဖြေလဲဆိုတော့ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဟာဖရားဖြစ်တယ်ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖရားဟာတကိုးကြီးတယ်နေရာတိုင်းမှာရှိတယ်စသဖြင့်ကျွန်တော်ဖြေခဲ့ပါတယ်
And then the man that asked the question stopped me and says, No, that's not the question I am asking. He says, I want to know what you know about the Holy Spirit's power and work and ministry in and through your life.
ငါမင်းနေတဲ့မိခွန်းကဒီတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖခင်ရဲ့တကိုးနဲ့သူ့ရဲ့သာသနာတင်းရဲ့အသက်တာမှာတင်းအားဖြင့်သူဘလောက်ထိလှုပ်ခဲ့ပြီးပြီလဲဆိုတာကိုမင်းဘလောက်သိတယ်လဲဆိုတာငါမင်းနေတာပ
ါ And when he asked the question that way I was stunned and I had no real answer to give that man
အဲ့လိုကျွန်တော်ကိုမေးလိုက်တဲ့အခါမှာကျွန်တော်နော်အဲ့အတင်းဆိုရဲနော်ငေးမောပြီးတော့ဘာတွေကိုပြန်ဖြေရမလဲဆိုတာမသိအောင်ကျွန်တော်အံ့ဩနေခဲ့ရပါတယ
် You see because I knew who the spirit was as a theology but I had no personal relationship with him
ကျွန်တော်ဟာတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖခင်ကိုဩဝါဒ theology သဘောတရားအနေနဲ့တော့ကျွန်တော်သိပေမဲ့ကျွန်တော်ရဲ့အသက်တာမှာကျတော့အဲ့ဒီဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖခင်နဲ့ဆက်နွယ်မှုကတော့လုံးဝလုံးဝမရှိခဲ့တယ်လို့ပါပဲ
And I think if we were to ask people that very same question, what is the Holy Spirit to you? We would get a variety of answers.
ကျွန်တော်ထင်ပါတယ်ဒီနေ့မှာလူမြောက်များစွာကိုဒီမိခွန်းကိုကျွန်တော်တို့မေးခဲ့တယ်ဆိုပါဆိုတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဘုရားကတင့်တော်ဘယ်သူလဲလို့မေးတဲ့အခါမှာမတူညီတဲ့အဖြေတွေကျွန်တော်တို့ပြန်ရမယ်လို့ကျွန်တော်ထင်ပါတယ
် Because to some people, the Holy Spirit is a theology. He's a doctrine. He's the third person of the Godhead.But nothing more.
တချို့သောသူတွေအတွက်တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်လို့ပြောလိုက်တာနဲ့ theology ကျွန်တော်တို့ဩဝါဒအနည်းအားဖြင့်ပြောမယ်ဆိုတော့၃ပါးတစုမှာပါဝင်တဲ့တပါးဖြစ်ပါတယ်ဆိုတာလောက်ပဲသူတို့ကသိတယ်အဲ့ဒါပဲအကုန်သူတို့သိတာ
To some Christians, the Holy Spirit is a mysterious unknown power that we try to get a hold of and use.
တချို့တွေကြတော့တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဟာဆိုရင်နော်ဒီအံ့ဩစရာကောင်းတဲ့စမ်းချေတဲ့ဆွမ်းအားလူမျိုးသူတို့ခံယူပြီးတော့အဲ့ဒီဆွမ်းအားကိုရတဲ့အခါမှာသူတို့ကြိုက်တယ်လို့အသုံးပြုလို့ရတဲ့အရာကဲ့သို့သူတို့ထင်မှတ်ကြတယ
် And to some the Holy Spirit is a servant whom we call upon when we need some kind of spiritual help
တချို့တွေတွက်ကြတော့လေဝိညာဉ်တော်ဟာဆိုရင်တော့လိုအပ်တဲ့အချိန်မှာကောက်ခေါ်လို့ရတဲ့နော်အစေခံတပါးလူမျိုးပဲသူတို့သဘောထားကြတယ်
But the question I want us to consider tonight is this question, what is the Holy Spirit to you?
Abe ni ya ma chuno di mi kun le go a lo ye nalon da le ma le le ne ne sin chin se chin ma le tan shin do win yin do di tin atwa bdu mya ba le.
Because your answer to that question will determine what kind of a Christian life you live.
Apilo le so ro tin phie de a phie ga tin belo myo christian atat da ko atat shin ni de le so de a ya ko tu ga song phyat twa le ni.
It will determine whether you live a fruitful or a fruitless Christian life.
Tin ha de ge be a ti a pwin ne a we sa ni de christian la a ti pwin ma shi de chauk kat ni de christian la so ga ai de a ya ga be song phyat twa ba ni me.
So what is the Holy Spirit to you? That is our question tonight.
Minya ma chano pya me chin ba le tan shin do win yin do phya ha tin atwa bidu ba le.
And one thing is true about the Holy Spirit, he is a divine person.
Tan shin do win yin do ne patat de a ya ma ta kae ko te cha de a ya man kan de a ya ga tu ha so yin do phya phit de tu ha pauk ko le phit ma.
And I think that one reason the Spirit of God is nothing to so many people is because they see him less than a divine person. Many times we see and treat the Spirit of God as a mere influence, a power, or sometimes we see him as an impersonal it. But one thing is absolutely true about the Holy Spirit. He is divine. He is God.
တိကျတာတခုကတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဟာ divine ဆိုတဲ့သူဟာဖယားဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုတဲ့အရာပါပဲ.
We read in Matthew 28 verse 19 that he is co-equal with God the Father and God the Son.
ရှင်မသည်နဲ့ဆက်ပိုင်းရဲ့စကားကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ကြည့်မယ်ဆိုရင်တော့ကျွန်တော်ဘာကိုတွေ့နိုင်လဲဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖယားဟာဆိုတော့ခမဲတော်ဖယားနဲ့သားတော်ဖယားနဲ့သူဟာဆိုရင်တော့ sin to
In Acts chapter 5, he is called God. And in John 6, he's the member of the Godhead that gave us our very life.
Yohan kanji chaku pachi ba, tu ha so ye. တော်ပါတဲ့ဆိုတဲ့မှာပါဝင်ပြီးတော့ကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုအသက်ပေးတဲ့အရှင်ဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုတာလည်းတွေ့ရတယ
် But the spirit of God is not just divine, he is a divine person.
ဒါမဲ့တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဘုရားဟာဆိုရင်တော့ divine ဆိုတဲ့ဘုရားပဲမဟုတ်ပဲねသူဟာဆိုရင်တော့ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်လည်းဖြစ်တယ်ဒါကြောင့်မလို့ဘုရားလည်းဖြစ်တယ်ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်လည်းဖြစ်ပ
ါ And as a person it means that he's not just a power, he's not a force.He's not an influence, and he's not an impersonal it.
That's why we don't know when you're not here, so you know. No, so I should be more good to have, so I be more good. So I'm only the I be more good, the go be more good. You should do ha. It's a step me. No, don't do that. Channel got the bomb attack.
The greatest teaching on the Holy Spirit was given by Jesus in John 14, 15, and 16.
ကျွန်တော်တို့တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်နဲ့ပတ်သက်တဲ့သင်ကြားခြင်းမှာနော်အထူးမြတ်ဆုံးသောသင်ကြားခြင်းကိုယေရှုခရစ်တော်ကရှင်ယောဟန်ခရစ်ဝင်ကျအခန်းကြီး14အပိုက်ငယ်14 15 16မှာသူသင်ပေးထားပါတယ
် And 12 times Jesus mentions the ministry of the Holy Spirit.
ဆက်တဲ့ကြီးကြီးတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ဘုရားရဲ့အမှုတော်မြတ်နဲ့ပတ်သက်ပြီးတော့ခရစ်တော်ကဖော်ပြထားခဲ့ပါ
And never once in all of those teachings does he refer to the Spirit of God as anything less than a person. In fact, in John chapter 16 and verse 13, Jesus refers repeatedly to the Spirit of God as a he, not an it. Over and over again, he refers to him with this personal pronoun, he, not an it, not an influence, not a mere power, but a person. And because the Holy Spirit is a person, you know, the Holy Spirit can love and he can guide and he can care. As a person, he can correct and he can comfort and he can counsel. And as a person, he can empower us and enable us, and he can teach us and he can instruct us. The Holy Spirit is a divine person. In fact, as a divine person, we can pray to the Holy Spirit. In fact, Jesus told us to pray to the Spirit when he made this statement in Matthew chapter 9, verse 37 and verse 38. Remember, Jesus said that the harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few. And then he said, pray to the Lord of the harvest that he would send forth laborers into the harvest. And the Holy Spirit is the Lord of the harvest. You see, it's the Holy Spirit who leads men and women into service. It's the Spirit that leads people to the place and to the people who need to be saved. It was the Holy Spirit who led Philip to the Ethiopian eunuch in Acts chapter 8. It was the Holy Spirit who said, separate unto me Paul and Barnabas for the work in which I have called them in Acts 13. It was the Holy Spirit who led Paul to Troas, where he heard that Macedonian call, come and help us. It was the Holy Spirit who led Paul to Philippi. And in Philippi, he led Paul to a lady by the name of Lydia. And it was that same Spirit that opened Lydia's heart to the gospel. You see, the Holy Spirit is the Lord of the harvest. And we are to be talking to him about the harvest. You see, we need to be asking the Holy Spirit to lead us to the place and to the people that need the gospel. We need to ask the Holy Spirit to do what only He can do. Remember, it's the Holy Spirit that convinces people of sin, righteousness, and God's coming judgment. We need to ask the Spirit of God to open people's eyes so that they would be saved and regenerated. We need to ask the Spirit of God to teach us and to give us the words to say when we need to say them. In John chapter 14 and verse 16, Jesus made this statement about the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, "And I will pray to the Father, and he shall give you another comforter that he might abide with you forever." In other words, Jesus says, when I go up, I'm going to send down somebody just like me, and that's the Holy Spirit.
Now, Sagatamio in a Yamas, you know, Crito got a better itama, Nga Kangi Gutatuare Kama, Nane Tatu, Tanya Pide, Acha, Tamariago, Timbid, and Nautiago, Nasiru Mel, Yorakiba.
And the Holy Spirit will stand in Christ's place. He will be to us just as Jesus was to the disciples.
Pashalo Wingin of Yaga, Tanorune to Amieda.
And just as the disciples communicated with the Lord Jesus, we're to communicate with the Holy Spirit. And just as the disciples asked the Lord to teach them, we're asked the Spirit of God to be our divine teacher. You see, if the Holy Spirit is a divine person who is co-equal with God the Father and God the Son, then we should be praying to him. And if you are not praying to the Holy Spirit, I ask you this question: what then is the Holy Spirit to you? If you're not talking to him about the harvest, then he's not a person to you. He's just a power. He's just a force, and he's just an it. And maybe that's why you don't know his power upon your life, your work, and your ministry. And you know that as a divine person, we can also thank him. In fact, we can praise him. You know, if we ask the Spirit of God to do something and he does it, we need to thank him and praise him for it. You see, if the Holy Spirit has led us to go somewhere and to do something, we need to thank him for what he's done. If the Holy Spirit has taught you a wonderful truth from the Word of God, we should thank him for it. We should praise him for his teaching. You see, if the Holy Spirit has used you in the life of an individual, then we should thank him for it. If the Holy Spirit has brought comfort to your heart, then we should thank him for it. Do you realize that Paul gave thanks to the Holy Spirit for empowering his witness in Acts chapter 20? Remember, Paul gave the Holy Spirit credit for being that member of the Godhead that hindered him from going to Bithynia and Galatia. Paul gave the Holy Spirit credit for being that member of the Godhead that led him to Macedonia. You see, Paul treated the Holy Spirit as a divine person. And we must likewise be treating the Spirit of God for who he is, and that's a divine person. You know, we often thank and we honor God the Father and God the Son. But when was the last time that you thanked and praised God the Holy Spirit? You know that if we ask the Holy Spirit to do something for us and he does it and we never thank him, do you know that we are insulting him? You know, if one day you and I were driving together in my car on a wet and a rainy day.
Okay, so basu tane ro tene chano ga no ayango
And my tire blew out and it went flat in the car. And I said to you, I said, you know, would you please get out in the rain and in the mud and the wind and fix my tire? And you say yes. And so you, out of the kindness of your heart, you fix the tire and you get back in the car, and there you are, you're wet and you're all muddy. And I look at you and I say, oh, please don't get my car wet. But I never say to you, thank you for fixing my tire. Thank you for getting all wet and all muddy for me. If I never say thank you, you know what we call that? We call that rude and very insulting. And how would that make you feel? Well, probably would make you feel pretty bad and not respected. But you realize that when we ask the Spirit of God to do something and he does it and we don't thank him and praise him for it, we are insulting him. In fact, if we don't thank him for what he does, we are treating him less than a person.
And
no wonder we don't know him personally and we don't experience his power. It's because we're treating him less than a divine person. But he is a divine person. And as a divine person, we are to be talking to him. We're to be thanking him. And we can also trust him. You know, we can trust the Holy Spirit because he is a divine person. We can trust him to lead us, to teach us, to take us to people and places where the gospel needs to go. You see, we can trust him to give us wisdom and to make wise and right decisions in life. We can trust the Spirit of God to give us the words to say when we need to say them. We can trust the Holy Spirit to give us victory over sin and power in service. We can trust the Holy Spirit in the lives of others. We can trust the Spirit of God to raise up new leaders and to lead our leaders. You see, we can trust him because he is a divine person. Do you realize that it was because Peter trusted the Holy Spirit that we as Gentiles received the gospel? Remember that story is found in Acts chapter 11. Remember, Peter was in Joppa, and in prayer, he received a vision of all kinds of four-footed animals. And remember, a voice said to Peter, "Peter, rise, kill, and eat." And remember, Peter, being a Jew, seeing all of these unclean animals, he said to the voice, "Lord, no way, I am not going to rise and eat and kill these animals." And that voice said, "Peter, what God has made clean, do not call unclean." And remember, this vision was not about Peter eating unclean animals. It was about Peter taking the gospel to the unclean Gentile world. And this vision came to Peter three times. And on the third time, here's what Peter said. It's found in Acts chapter 11 and verse 12. Here's what Peter said. Peter said, "The Holy Spirit told me, go to the Gentiles, doubting nothing." And Peter trusted the Holy Spirit. And as a result, the Gentiles, that's you and I, we received the gospel.
And
friends, in the very same way, when the Spirit of God speaks, we must trust him. Why? Because he is a divine person and he can be trusted. Years ago, when I was pastoring a church in Singapore, I was teaching on the personality of the Holy Spirit. And I was telling our church that we can trust the Holy Spirit because he's a divine person. And one a young lady in our church, she was a university student, decided that she was going to trust this divine person of the Holy Spirit. And before she left the church that morning, she prayed and said, Holy Spirit, would you lead me to somebody who needs to hear the gospel today? And within an hour, she was walking through the market, and there she saw a young Malay lady sitting at a food stall. And this young lady was Malay by birth, and she was Islamic by religion. But the Holy Spirit said, speak to her about the gospel. But this young church sister, as you can imagine, was a little bit hesitant. She began to argue with the Lord and said, but Lord, this cannot be the person you want me to witness to. She's Islamic. But the Holy Spirit said, no, I want you to speak. So she began to bargain with the Lord. She said, okay, Lord, if you want me to speak to this lady, when I turn around, have her look at me in the eyes and give me a smile, and I'll know you want me to speak to her. So as she turned around, this young lady, Malay by birth, Islamic by religion, looked up, met her in the eye and gave her a big smile. So our church sister trusted the Holy Spirit, walked over, sat down, and began to share the gospel with this young lady. And God began to open the heart of this Islamic lady, and within 30 minutes, she placed her faith and her trust in Jesus Christ. And then this young lady said this to our church sister. She said, although I come from an Islamic home, I wanted to be a Christian for the last 4 years, and nobody was able to tell me how until now.
So no ai no Islam badawin ka mali ka belo tatte khan get le so yin no oga ha Islam badawin go mita su ga ni no mita su ri ga alu lu phit de twa chaung phit khe be me lun ge de le ni da kala twin ma chama ga kriyan yan phit chin khe be me kriyan phit phu yan twa ba ri lo at le belo ri phit de le so da go pyo pya me do ma shi bu di ni ma be chama na le de so bi lo tatte khan ni.
You see, friends, the Holy Spirit is a divine person, and we can trust him. You see, if you're not talking to, thanking, and trusting the Holy Spirit, then what is the Holy Spirit to you? Maybe he's to you just a theology. He's just knowledge. He's just a piece of information. And maybe that's why you don't regularly see his power in your life. So the Holy Spirit, first of all, is a divine person. But please know that he is a divine person of dynamic power. You see, the Holy Spirit is a person of power that is co-equal with the power of God the Father and God the Son. Remember, it was the Holy Spirit that assisted God the Father in the creation of this world. It was the Holy Spirit who gave life to that lump of clay and brought forth man.
It was the Holy Spirit
that took 40 men, and without violating their personality, he brought forth a book that we call the Bible, because that's his inspiration. It was the Holy Spirit that placed that seed in Mary's womb and brought forth God the Son wrapped in human flesh. It was the Holy Spirit that gave Jesus Christ victory over Satan in the wilderness. It was the Spirit of God that enabled Jesus Christ to wipe the drops of blood from his brow and thus endure the shame and the pain of the cross. It was the Spirit of God that raised Christ's lifeless body from the dead. You see, this divine person is a person of dynamic power. And believer, do you realize that this divine person of dynamic power lives in you.
Yongjiru may swim ya dini ma, chanaru tabopo chadala, paya pide, payale pide, pokule pipiro, chimare, dagushin pide, tanshendo wingin do piara, dagero, teatema, chingwene rama.
Listen to what Paul said in 1 Corinthians chapter 3 and verse 16.
Tiko kanji.
He said to this church, he says, do you not know that you are the temple of God and that the Spirit of God lives in you? And I think many of God's people today are just like these Corinthians. They don't know that the Holy Spirit lives in them. You see, dwelling within us is this divine person of dynamic power. And if the Holy Spirit dwells within you, should not his presence be making a difference in your life? You see, his presence should be making a difference in every area of your life. You see, in our life, there should be peace and contentment rather than fear and worry. Because the Holy Spirit dwells in you, there should be love and forgiveness rather than hate and revenge. Because he lives within you, there should always be a song on your tongue and joy in your heart. Because this divine person of dynamic power lives within you, husbands should be enabled to love their wives. Wives will be able to respect their husbands. Children will be empowered to obey their parents. Parents will be enabled to raise their children in the nurture and the admonition of the Lord. You see, because the Spirit of God dwells within you, he should empower you to witness with boldness. He'll provide power to be victorious over sin and Satan. He'll give you strength to meet every single challenge of every single day. And if this divine person of dynamic power isn't making a difference in your life, it's because you have not made him your daily partner. And Paul speaks of making the Holy Spirit your daily partner in 2 Corinthians chapter 13 and verse 14. And here's what Paul says. He says, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. And the word communion here refers to a partner. You see, the Spirit of God wants to be your daily partner. You know, four times Jesus Christ called the Holy Spirit a comforter. And the word comforter refers to one who's been called alongside of you to give you aid. In other words, Jesus is reminding us that the Holy Spirit is a divine person of dynamic power who is called alongside of us to be our daily partner.
And
as your daily partner, he wants to enable our walk and he wants to empower our work and our witness. And you see, if the Holy Spirit is going to be our daily partner, enabling our walk and our witness, then we must allow him to be the leader of our lives. You see, the Holy Spirit is only free to work in and through our lives as we yield ourselves to his control and his leadership. You see, it's only when he is in control of my life are my feet free to go where he wants me to go. It's only when the Spirit of God is the leader of my life are my lips free to speak what he wants me to speak. It is only when he is leader and in control of my life will I see what he wants me to see. It is only when he is leader and in control will my mind be free to think what he wants me to think. It's only when he is leader and in control will my heart love what he wants me to love. You see, we must yield ourselves to his control and allow him to be the leader of my life. It is only when he is the leader of my life will I know his power in my walk, my work, my witness, and even in my worship. Let me give you three simple thoughts about the Holy Spirit's leadership, and then we'll be done tonight. You see, if the Holy Spirit is going to be our leader, then we need to realize that it is not you and I trying to use the Holy Spirit, but it's you and I allowing the Holy Spirit to use us. You see, leadership is not you and I asking the Holy Spirit to be our helper. You see, when you ask someone to help you, you are the one in control. They're helping you. Before God called me to be a preacher, I worked as a chef in hotels. As a chef, I was in charge. I was the boss, and I had a lot of cooks that were there to help me. The cooks were there to help me get my will done. I was not there to help them get their will done. They were there to help me. I wasn't there to help them. And in the same way, you see, the Spirit of God is not here to help me get my will done on earth. But you see, the Spirit of God is there to use me to accomplish his will on this earth. So it's not us using the Spirit of God to accomplish my plan and my purpose and my will. But it is me being so yielded to the Spirit's leadership that he is free to use me to accomplish his will in this life. And when we see the Holy Spirit as our helper to accomplish our will, we wind up robbing ourselves of his power and his control in our life.
Let
me tell you a true story.
ဖြစ်ပျက်တစ်ခုလေးเนาะကျွန်တော်ပြောပြပါရစေ In 1921
a man by the name of Douglas Brown was the pastor of a Baptist church in England
1921 မှာ ကျွန်တော်တို့ Douglas Brown ဆိုတဲ့ ပုဂ္ဂိုလ် တယောက်က England နိုင်ငံ နှစ်ချက် သင်းတော်မှာ သင်ဟောဆရာလုပ်ခဲ့ပါတယ်
And for months the Holy Spirit was calling him to leave his church and to go into evangelism.
And
when he surrendered the Spirit's call to evangelism, he left his church. And the Holy Spirit told him to go to a fishing village in another part of England and hold a series of evangelistic meetings. And he obeyed the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And it is said from the very first night of those evangelistic meetings that hundreds of people were born again. And this began a moving of the Holy Spirit in revival that lasted from 1921 to 1922, and thousands of people were born again. And this is classified as England's last revival. And this man, Douglas Brown, preached the gospel 1,700 times in 17 months.
Douglas Brown has been, no, Edwin Galitiago, no, Adi Achei, the town Kunatown, no, Tankunia Jotuga, the second a lot, Dreamer to the Adina Hogeva.
It is said that so powerful was the moving of the Holy Spirit that everywhere he went, hundreds of people were born again. When godly men heard how the Holy Spirit was using Douglas Brown, they formed a committee and they came to Mr. Brown.
Douglas Brown ko phaya ka chi ma so a tong pyu de so da ko lu ni ka ti de a kha ma thuru committee phwe pi lo di Dr. Brown chi ma thuru la pi lo saka la pyo de
and they said Mr. Brown God the Holy Spirit is using you and we want to spread this revival throughout England so please let us start booking your meetings and tell you which city and which church you should preach in
Mr. Brown Mr. Brown
And Mr. Brown agreed, and no longer was he free to be led by the Holy Spirit. Now he was being led by this committee of men.
So, Mr. Brown got through pure as a guy with the board to light it. Eddie Tabo to Reniga, Lisabido to Hawing, you know, Usan Chengo to Gamakayaro Ben, eh? Be a poor sea, Pokuri, Usan Chiama to Yawagaran.
And after 1 month, Mr. Brown stood before this committee of men and he had tears in his eyes.
Now the Lajama, the Apuesishima, Mr. Brownga, to Mataya, Birotrushima, Mayirine.
And he says, Men, please pray for me, for I have lost the power of the Spirit of God upon my life. You see, as quickly as that revival started, it stopped because these men forgot that leadership and the control of the Holy Spirit is not you and I using the Spirit of God to accomplish our will, but being so yielded to the Spirit of God that he can accomplish his will through us. And then the leadership of the Holy Spirit, number two, is an active cooperation with the Spirit. It is not you and I simply being idle. You see, the leadership and control of the Holy Spirit is not you and I sitting back, you know, with our eyes closed, waiting and meditating for some sign from God. You see, being under the control of the Spirit is an active cooperation with the Holy Spirit. It's kind of like driving a car. I don't get in the car, turn the engine on, begin driving, and say, "Oh, Holy Spirit, I want you to take control." So I take my hands off the steering wheel and I close my eyes. That's not leadership. That's what we call being lunacy. But you see, the leadership of the Holy Spirit, it'd be like me driving the car and the Holy Spirit is in the passenger seat. And as I'm driving the car, I'm listening to the leadership of the Holy Spirit. And all of a sudden, the Holy Spirit says, "Turn right." And because he's the leader of my life, I turn right. And then he says, "Turn left." And because he's the leader of my life, I turn left. And then he says, "Stop." And because he is the leader of my life, I do what he says, I stop. And then he points at a person and he says, "Speak." And because he is the leader of my life, I speak. You see, the leadership of the Holy Spirit is an active cooperation with this divine person of dynamic power so he can be your daily partner.
You
see, if he's going to be your daily partner, when he speaks, you must obey. That's leadership.
And
here's the last thought. You see, the leadership of the Holy Spirit is not you getting more of the Holy Spirit, but it's you allowing the Holy Spirit to get more of you. You see, if we think of the Holy Spirit, maybe it's just as a power or an influence, or if we see him as an it, our thought will always be, how can I get more of it? But it's not you getting more of him, because you received all of him at the moment of your salvation. But it is you allowing him to get more control over you. You see, it's only when the Holy Spirit is our leader and in control of our life will we know his dynamic power and partnership in our life. You see, it's only when he is our leader and in control will he be able to empower our work, our walk, and our witness for the glory of God. Let me end tonight's message with this story. And I'm going to end with the story that we started with about this man, Dr. Walter Wilson. After the missionary asked him the question, what is the Holy Spirit to you? He went to hear a message very similar to what you are hearing tonight on the partnership of the Holy Spirit. And when the message was coming to an end, the pastor quoted Romans chapter 12 and verse 1, and he said this about that passage. He says, have you ever noticed in this passage that we are not told specifically who we are to give our bodies to? He said, Paul said we are to present our bodies, but we are not to present our bodies to God the Father. He's on the throne. We are not to present our bodies to God the Son because he has his resurrected body.
no yesu christ do ta do phya tan ma le de ke do twa pi do pe sia ma lo bu tu ma tu ye shin pyan tha myo pi da khanda ko tu ko pai ma shi ni bi.
But we are to present our bodies to the Holy Spirit because our bodies are his temple. And then he asked the question, have you done that? Have you presented your body to the Spirit's control? And when Dr. Wilson heard that, he knew that that was his deepest need, that he needed to allow the Holy Spirit to be his leader and to be under his control.
Dr. Wilson ga eri ya bu tu cha le kha ma oh da nga ye alu at song do ya be nga ye atet da bu win yin do phya ka long long ma thain chauk pe bu sa ku ti ni de.
So he went home that night, and there on the side of his bed he asked the Holy Spirit to be his leader and asked the Spirit of God to enable him to live under the Spirit's control.
Eri ya ma tu ha so yo tu ye ai ya be na le ma du thao pi lo tu gan wo pi lo win yin do phya chano ye di khana ko atet da ko lo lo thain chauk ba ro so yo tu a song pe lai.
The next morning he got up and he said to his wife, he said, honey, today is going to be a wonderful day because last night I surrendered my life to the leadership and the control of the Holy Spirit.
Namale no la re kha ma tu ye myo thami ko tu ga pyon pi lo wan myaw sa ne tu belo pyo le sin naw a chi ye no meima ye di nei bo chi ma le a ya phit la lei mi ba phit lo le sin naw ma ni ya ga nga ye khanda ko nga ye bwa ta khu long ko win yin naw ye u saung chin ne tu ye thain chung mu aw ma nga tu so lai bi sakat lai bi le tu pyo shin so a pyo le.
And the next and that day when he went into his medical clinic, two ladies came into his office and they were selling something.
So ro tu ye office ma ai ni ma tu thai ni de lu ne yak anu thami ne yak ga no di pisi yang ni de anu thami ne yak ga tu si ko la.
And as he was listening to these two ladies, the Holy Spirit spoke and said, share with them the gospel.
Ni anu thami ne yak na de kha ma tan shin do win yin do ga tu ye tatta ma a lo lo pi lo saka pyo lhon son ni de ai di anu thami ne yak go evangeli win kha ba.
And because the Holy Spirit was now his leader and he was under the Spirit's control, he spoke and he shared the gospel with these two ladies. And those two ladies were wonderfully born again, and that began a life of evangelistic fruitfulness for this man, Dr. Walter Wilson.
Eri nu thami ni yak chat chin me eri ni ma ketin chin ko thuru ya twa ke ba ne eri ni ga ni sa pi lo Dr. Wilson ne tadana amu do myet ma sin lo a ti pwin ni sa tin bi lo wi sa chin ha sa tin na ke de.
Eventually he founded a church, a Bible college, and even a mission board.
Now so ma tu ha sin lo a tin do ko le ti thaw me chan sa chang ko le sa tin bi lo amu do mya amu do sa ni ko thaw pa ne mission board chi ko le tu ma sa tin ke ba.
And Dr. Wilson said this, he said, the change that took place that day when he placed himself under the leadership of the Holy Spirit made a greater difference in his life than his salvation experience.
Dr. Wilson ga now ma belo pyan tat te khan le sin lo eri ni ma chano ye tet da ko win yin no phya tha ma lo lo thain chung ko chano pu so second light de akha ma eri atet da ye chi ma de phit pyet de aya de ga chano ke tin chi ya kha sa do ma phit pyet de aya thet daw ma pu pi do daw ma thu cha pi do a thi ya mu shi de lo chano khan sa de.
So I ask you tonight, what is the Holy Spirit to you?
ညမှာလည်းပဲကျွန်တော်အားလုံးကိုမိန့်ခွန်းပေးခြင်းနဲ့ယုံကြည်သူမိတ်ဆွေများဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖခင်ဟာတင့်အတွက်ပဲသူပါလေ.
Have you made this divine person of dynamic power your daily partner?
ဒီဖခင်ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ဖြစ်တဲ့တကောရှင်ဖြစ်တဲ့ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖခင်ကိုတင့်ရဲ့နေ့ရက်စဉ်တိုင်းအတွက်ဦးဆောင်ပေးတဲ့အဖော်တင့်ကိုထိန်းချုပ်တဲ့အဖော်ဖြစ်ဖို့တင်လုံးဝပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ကိုအနှံပေးပြီလား
. Have you made him your leader? Have you placed yourself under his control?
tu ye u sa mu atwet tin ku 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 anan bi bi la tu ye chain chou phu yan atwet tu ye let out ma tin ko tin a chain chou khan phu yan atwet set kat bi bi la
if not then what is the Holy Spirit to you
era re ma lo te bu so yin chano me gon me me eri win yin lo phya ka da so yin tin twet be tu nya le
let's bow for prayer
su daw ja ba so
Lord, we just thank you for that wonderful salvation that brought to us the blessed person of the Holy Spirit.
Oh, Guru Shin Pia di ni ma, chanaro ke din chin ya re ni ma, chanaro atat da ma, chanaro atwe, chanaro atte ma, chin wade, tan shin lo wing yin o pia atwe, chizu te mai.
And Lord, I pray for your people tonight.
Oh, Guru Shin ye luri dwe, di nya ma, chanaro su ta mai.
Lord, that tonight each of us would make that exchange. That we would exchange the leadership and control of our life, allowing your spirit to lead and control our life. Lord, we want your spirit to empower our work, our walk, and our witness for your glory. We ask this in Jesus' name, amen.
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 God bless you.
Amen.
What a wonderful and powerful message we heard tonight. It is really a blessing to every one of us. So many times we heard about the Holy Spirit and the doctrine of the Holy Spirit theologically, but tonight we heard once again what the Holy Spirit to us. He is a divine person. Tonight we heard that we can talk with him and we can thank him and we can touch him. What a wonderful message. And the Holy Spirit is a dynamic power, and then he is the Lord, our daily partner. So I come to know that surrendering ourselves under the total control of the Holy Spirit is the key of our Christian life and service. So thank you very much, Pastor Mike, for your wonderful and powerful message tonight that you brought us.
Amen. ဖြူဝချက်အောင်မြင်ချင်းဖြူဝချက်တော့ချက်ကိုကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုလက်ဆောင်ပေးတယ်လို့ကျွန်တော်မြင်တွေ့ရပါတယ်။ဘာကြောင့်လဲဆိုတော့ဒီညမှာတန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်အကြောင်းဒီဩဝါဒတွေစာပေဖတ်ဘူးပါတယ်။ဒီညအတိကဂျာနာပေါ်တဲ့အရာကပြန်ချုံငုံပြီးအနေငယ်ပြောမယ်ဆိုရင်တန်ရှင်သောဝိညာဉ်တော်ကျွန်တော်တို့အတွက်ဘသူလဲ။သူဒီကျွန်တော်တို့အတွက်ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်တစ်ပါးဖြစ်တယ်။ဖခင်တစ်ပါးဖြ nan khulung a khulu ya de su de a chang u pathama a ne ne tu di pukku da ba phit chang ja na khe ba de dutiya ma tan shin do win yin do ha ta ku ji la do pukku da ba phit chang u chano ru ja na ya ba de chano ru a ne shin a tet ta ma pyaung le mu ri lut tin ne mita su ma a pyaung le mu ri lut tin ne chano ru si pwe lo nga a mu ro lo nga ma le tu ko a khwan pe yin ne pyaung le mu mya so lut tin de တကူးကြီးတော့ဖရာဖြစ်ကြောင်းဦးဒီကနေ့ညမှာတန်ရှင်တော်ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဒီတကူးကြီးတော်ပုဂ္ဂိုလ်ဖြစ်ကြောင်းကြားနာရတယ်ဒါပြအချက်ကျွန်တော်ကြားနာခဲ့တဲ့အရာကတန်ရှင်တော်ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖရာဒီနေရှင်မစ်ဆွေအပေါင်းအဖော်ဖြစ်ကြောင်းလဲကြားနာခဲ့ပါတယ်သူ့ရဲ့အူဆောင်ခြင်းတခင်ဖြစ်ခြင်းသူ့၌စိတ်ကပ်ခြင်းဟာကျွန်တော်တို့အတွက်အောင်မြင်ခြင်းဖြစ်တယ်ဆိုတာလေးကိုကြားနာရတာအမတ ီတူအားလုံးကြားနာသူလည်းခွန်အားရကြမယ်လို့ကျွန်တော်မျှော်လင့်ပါတယ်ဒီနေ့ညနောက်ဆုံးအစီအစဉ်အနေနဲ့ကျွန်တော်တို့ BST ခေါ်ရ group ကနေကုံတော်ချီးမွမ်းပြီးတော့မှ Now soon, then let call Siamaluang. Sia Lukaya suit down chin and dinya, she's in Yupin Jama Tibare. BST choir group now, you should credo Nama Tikovare.
ဒါရှင်တော်ဖျားကိုရောရှူစွာချီးမွမ်းပါတယ်ဒီညကြားရတဲ့တရားဒေသနာအပြင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ဂျာနာသူတယောက်ချင်းစီတိုင်းရဲ့အတ္တတာမှာအမှန်တကယ်စကားပြောရဲဆိုတာသိတာထင်ရှားလာပါတယ်သူတို့ဖြင့်ဒီတရားဒေသနာကိုကြားရတဲ့အခါမှာကျွန်တော်တို့အူးချင်းစီတိုင်းရဲ့အတ္တတာမှာဝင်ချတောင်းပန်ရမယ့်အရာရှိသလိုဂျေဇုတော်ချီးမွမ်းရမယ့်အရာနဲ့အတူလိုက်လျှောက်ကျင့်သုံးရမယ့်အရာလဲ ချင်းချင်းရှာရှာတွေ့မြင်ရတော့ခွင့်ပေးအတွက်ကျေးဇူးတင်ပါတယ်ဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖျားကိုအစဉ်မြဲကျွန်တော်တို့တိမှတ်ရက်ထိုဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖျားရဲ့ဥဆောင်မှုအောက်မှာထိုဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖျားလမ်းညွှန်မှုအတိုင်းအမှုတော်မြတ်မှာတော်၎င်းကျွန်တော်ရဲ့နေ့စဉ်အတ္တတာမှာတော်၎င်းအသက်ရှင်ခြင်းနဲ့တက်ဖို့ရန်အတွက်အတ္တတဖန်ထိုဝိညာဉ်တော်ဖျားကိုယ်တိုင်ကပင်လင်ကျွန်တော်တို့ကိုစကားပြောပါမိအကြောင်း ဆိုတာပြောရင်းနဲ့အတူကျွန်တော်ရဲ့အသက်တာများကို correction ဆက်လက်ဥဆောင်ပေးပါမိအကြောင်းယေရှုတော်လုံလောက်ကြောင်းဝန်ခံရယေရှုနာမအမည်ဖြင့်ဆုတောင်းဆက်ကအနာမာရဖဖျားရှင်အာမင
်အာမင
်အာမင်ဆုတင်ပါတယ်မနေ့ပြန်ညရှိသေးတယ်ဒီလမနော်ဒီတစ်ပတ်မနေ့ပြန်နဲ့တစ်ဖက်ခါလဲအားလုံးပါဝင်ဖို့တမပတိအနေနဲ့ပြန်လည်ဖြစ်ခေါ်လိုပါတယ်
အလုံးဝကြည့်ဒီမှာလေမနေ့ပြညလည်းပဲ9နာရီ6နာရီခွဲကနေယူဝင်လို့ရပါတယ် Sunday morning မြန်မာအစံတော်ချိန်က9နာရီမှာကျွန်တော်ဝက်ပြုအစီအဝေးရှိပါမယ် Holy Spirit ကို celebrate အကျန်လာရမှာဖြစ်ပါတယ် Sunday ညမှာဆိုရင်ခါတိုင်းပဲ9နာရီကနေစမယ်6နာရီခွဲကနေယူဝင်လို့ရပါတယ်အလုံးကိုကြည့်ကြပါရစေ။တရားဟောဆရာရှင်မကျူတီစကားပြောကြပါလား။ Thank you very much Pastor Mike. Wonderful message.
အ
Amen. You're welcome.
Thank you, Asia. God bless you. Oh.
Hey, hey. Thank you, Scott Yao Java.
As Mike, thank you very much for the message tonight. May God bless you and use you more and more for many people. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. Appreciate that. God bless you as well. May God use you to reach your world for his glory. Amen. Thank you.
Amen. Thank you.
See you tomorrow.
Good night, all. God bless.